Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In this quick video, I will show you how to create your own custom silicone keyboard dampener for less than 30 bucks. Make sure and stick around to the very end so that you don't miss a step. You guys ready? Let's go. So the first thing you'll need is some masking tape, followed by a small disposable measuring cup, a wooden stir stick, a toothpick, a disposable cup, and last but not least, the silicone compound you plan on using. I personally recommend going with this Miracle-Coo 1-to-1 ratio compound as it's fairly easy to use and affordable. I'll make sure and put the link down in the description below. Now that we have that out of the way, take out your keyboard case and start to tape up any holes or openings you might find on the base. In this video, I'll be using the Drop Plank 40% mechanical keyboard. The idea here is to make sure that the silicone compound has no place or hole where it could possibly leak from. Make sure and pay extra attention to the corners where the base of the case meets the walls. Once the keyboard case has been prepped, ensure that the case lays flat on whatever surface you'll be working on. Please note that if your keyboard has an angle, you'll have to use something to prop it up and then make adjustments accordingly using a level to make sure it lays flat. Now that all that boring stuff is out of the way, you're ready to start mixing your silicone compound. Now if you're building a 40% keyboard, you'll want to have 30 milliliters total to create your mold. That means pouring 15 milliliters of each bottle into a disposable cup. Make sure to not pour more than 15 milliliters of each, as if you do end up pouring more, you run the risk of your USB connector on your PCB unable to exit your case, which, as you can imagine, is no bueno. If you're building a 60% keyboard, then you can use a total of 50 milliliters, which means 25 milliliters of each bottle. If you're building anything above a 60%, then as a general rule of thumb, subtract 10 from the type of keyboard you're building and then divide by 2. That'll give you the amount of milliliters you would need to pour per each bottle. Once you've poured the silicone compounds into the disposable cup, make sure and stir both of the liquids for at least 5 minutes. Now, don't skip or half-ass this step, as it can easily ruin the overall results of your mold. Now that 5 minutes have passed, it's time to pour the silicone compound into the case of your keyboard. Ensure that you start to pour from the middle of your keyboard from one end to the other. Don't worry about the edges at this point, just make sure that all the compound has been poured. Feel free to use the stir stick you used earlier to remove any excess silicone compound from the disposable cup. Once everything has been poured, pick up the case and move it around in a circular fashion, ensuring that every edge has its fair share of the compound. Once that's complete, set your case down to rest for 12 hours. At this point, do not move or touch the case. Just let it sit and allow time to do its thing in order to harden the silicone. Now that 12 hours have passed, peel off the corners of the tape around the case and slowly start to lift up the silicone from the case itself. Feel free to take your time and work each edge of the case from the outside in. If you happen to find any excess residue, no worries, you can simply wipe it off with some warm water and a towel. Once complete, place the silicone mold back in your case and make sure that all the edges line up. With a toothpick, you'll then want to poke holes through the silicone to the holes on the base of your case. Last but not least, feel free to mark up the silicone around the USB opening and with scissors, an X-Acto knife, or a box cutter, cut around it, allowing the USB connector from your PCB to exit the case. Once you've completed all these steps, congratulations, you now have a silicone dampener for your keyboard that works way better than any packaging foam you might have had previously. As always, if you liked the video, feel free to like, leave a comment, or subscribe to my channel. Until next time, guys, peace.